Doctor Who, The Dominators, by Norman Ashby. Episode 1. An armada of saucer-like craft moves through the blackness of deep space in an arrowhead formation. One saucer detaches itself from the others and sets course for a planet in a nearby solar system. The rest of the fleet continues relentlessly on its way, as, glowing with intense heat, the lone ship penetrates the planet's atmosphere and descends through layers of cloud towards a solitary island set in a misty ocean. The island is seemingly lifeless, a vista of sandstone cliffs, ashen valleys, and undulating dunes, amongst which the saucer finally comes to rest, a tripod of supporting legs extending from underneath to complete the touchdown. Eddies of sand whirl and settle round the craft's silvery hull as stillness returns briefly to the island. A vertical tube lowers from the belly of the saucer. The door to the elevator within opens, and a powerfully built, dark-haired man steps out. Humanoid, he wears a quilted, rubbery armor that is built up around his shoulders, such that he almost appears to have no neck. A similar figure stands close behind. These are Dominators. Imperious, arrogant, and detached, they survey the desolate landscape.
Is the local radiation completely absorbed?
Yes, its energy's been transferred to our fuel reserves. But we need much more.
Of course, that is why we're here.
With respect, Navigator Rago, I still consider we should have continued to Epsilon 4.
I decided otherwise, Probationer Tober.
But this planet has never been fully surveyed.
It's suitable for our purpose. The planetary crust is thin here, and there's an intelligent form of life suitable for a workforce.
But the natives may not be suitable for slave labor. Suppose they're hostile.
If necessary, we shall destroy them.
Yes, destroy them.
But only if necessary. Commence work on the preliminary survey.
Command accepted. Shall I order the Quarks to mark out the drilling sites?
Yes.
Quarks!
Commandingly, Toba looks back towards the darkness of the elevator. Out at sea, a white, dome-shaped hovercraft is gliding smoothly and quietly across the fog-shrouded waters. Inside, a young man, Warhead, stares out of a viewing window. Bored, he turns to his fellow passengers, Etnin and Talata, who are both lounging languidly in comfortable seats.
I'm not so sure that this so-called adventure was such a good idea after all. I mean, this is a terribly primitive way to travel, isn't it?
Well, we are supposed to be looking for excitement, aren't we?
That's why I came.
I really don't see what's so exciting about sitting for hours on end in this old tub. If we'd used a travel capsule, we could have been here in a few minutes.
Not without a permit, you wouldn't.
Cully, the pilot, is sitting at a small navigation console.
Suppose that does add a little zest.
Well, here we are, everyone. The Island of Death. Uninhabited for 170 years. Nothing can live on this poisonous plot of soil.
Cully gestures dramatically at the scanner, but his three companions look dubious.
You're being melodramatic again, Cully, as usual. You know perfectly well there's a permanent survey unit there to monitor the radiation.
And there's a weekly visit by parties of students to show them the horror of atomic radiation.
No, all right, I know. But all this is organized and supervised by the state.
You've traveled miles by sea in a ship navigated by man. None of your autopiloting.
And don't forget we're here without permits. All this is illegal.
Yes, I'd almost forgotten that.
An adventure with Cully is something never to be forgotten.
Doesn't look any different to me from the way I've seen it in vision books on my own screen at home.
Oh, but this time it's real.
Is it?
Well, yes, of course it is. You're actually here.
Are we?
You don't believe me.
Well, you could be throwing up old pictures on your scanner, couldn't you? After all, there's nothing to show that it is real.
Well, you can't get out and see.
Why not?
Yes, why not?
Look, I'm all for a bit of danger, but going out on that island without protective suits would be madness.
So we just have to take your word for it, Cully.
Yes, you do.
Didn't you mention something about a warning signal?
Hmm? Yes, when we're in the radiation zone, why?
Well, aren't we a bit close?
The island looms large on the screen.
Do something, Cully!
We're going to crash!
Quickly, Cully!
The craft impacts at the base of a cliff, and its occupants are thrown to the floor. Bruised and winded, they pick themselves up as the ship steadies itself. Cully checks his instrumentation.
We're stuck.
Hmm?
Oh, no!
Do you mean permanently?
Yes. We've run aground, and the drive is well and truly wedged in solid.
Well, how are we supposed to get back to the mainland?
Well, don't ask me. This really is an adventure, isn't it?
Are you sure this isn't one of your practical jokes, Cully?
Now, look. Running aground on an atomic island isn't my idea of fun.
Yes, but is that where we really are?
Whitehead tries the controls for himself.
The radiation meter's registering zero.
Yes. Odd. Well, they've probably broken down.
Let's try again, shall we? Clear the computers. Now.
Zero? But it can't be.
So much for your navigation, Cully. Island of Death.
All right. Go out there. Get yourselves cooked to a frazzle by the radiation. But don't come complaining to me if you get yourselves killed, because I don't refund money to... Refund? What am I saying? They haven't even paid me yet. Hey, wait!
Cully catches Talata in the doorway.
Oh, Talata, don't be a little fool. This island is a killer.
So you say, but your radiation counter didn't seem to be making too much of a fuss about it.
Yes, I know, but, well, it must have gone bust.
And all the others in this tub of yours as well.
Why don't you admit it, Cully? You're a rogue. This isn't the test island, is it?
But I tell you, it
is. Over the hill.
People.
Well, that settles it rather, doesn't it, Cully? No one ever visits the Island of Death, do they?
Well, the survey unit, or they could be students. Were they wearing protective suits? No. But they had a new type of robot.
A work party, most probably. Come on, Ednin. Let's go and seek their assistance in getting us off this dreary island, which Cully has so carelessly marooned us on.
Warhead and Talata scramble up the barren slope after Ednin, leaving Cully behind.
No, wait! Warhead! Stop!
Quarks, you will set up the drilling equipment in accordance with the programmed instructions of
At the entrance to the saucer, Toba is distracted by the three tourists running down the hill towards him. Cully appears over the brow. Sensing the danger, he shouts a warning.
Wait!
Quarks!
Stop!
Destroy them!
An electronic sight zooms into focus on the three cheerily waving figures.
Look it down, quickly!
Cully looks on, helpless.
You're going to... Get down!
There's a blast of searing energy, and the three friends fall lifeless to the ground. Sickened by the slaughter, Cully ducks back out of sight.
Quarks, reload force units.
Toba smiles in satisfaction at the smoking bodies. Rago steps from the saucer.
Trouble?
I've dealt with it. Three alien beings of the planet.
Dead.
Of course.
That was unnecessary!
Toba seethes with impotent anger as his superior storms back into the saucer. Cully is making his way back to his hovercraft. Numb with shock, he fails to register the blue police box exterior of the TARDIS fading into incongruous reality behind him. The doctor emerges from his machine, carrying a folding deck chair, fishing net, and inflatable beach ball. He's followed closely by Jamie and his new companion, Zoe.
You still feeling tired, Doctor?
Yes, just a little bit weary, Jamie. It's a very exhausting business, projecting all those mental images, you know.
You need a good rest, Doctor.
Yes, we all do a nice holiday.
Well, where do you say this place was again?
Well, the scanner screen in the TARDIS showed it as an island of some sort, surrounded by a sea of mist.
Yes, it's an island on Dulcis, a perfectly splendid planet.
Oh, I've had that one before.
And there won't be any Cybermen or Daleks, will there?
No, of course not. There's nothing unpleasant on Dulcis.
Look, is the whole island as dreary as this?
Oh, no, goodness me, no. They're a very advanced race, the Dulcians. And they're very gentle, too. And friendly. You're going to like them.
Oh, I see you've been here before.
Oh, yes, Jimmy. Blow that up for me, will you? Yes, some time ago, mind you. It was splendid. It was so peaceful, I just didn't want to leave. Yes, that's what we all need. A nice, peaceful holiday.
As the doctor settles in his deck chair, Jamie blows into the beach ball and exchanges a doubtful look with Zoe. Toba is standing on the cliff top overlooking Cully's ship. He looks down with destructive intent. Cully, too, is within sight of the little craft, having just finished descending the slope. Oblivious to the Dominator high above him, he pauses for a moment to catch his breath, then starts onward.
Quarks, destroy the alien vessel.
Now, sensing the danger, Cully dodges into hiding. The ship is blown apart in a rain of flaming...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.